Hi students, welcome to first year commerce class. In our previous class, we were discussing about the determinants of globalization. Why globalization has become essential in the recent times. So due to economic liberalization and development of science and technology and policies of the government, and requirements of people, expansion of global market, all this led to globalization. So as part of globalization, the establishment and expansion of multinational corporations also has increased. MNC stands for multinational corporation, or you can say multinational company. So MNC stands for multinational corporations. What is a multinational corporation? Try to understand. It will have a home country as well as host country. Remember this point. Suppose say Pepsi is a multinational company. Its head office is in America, say USA. Okay, but its branches are there all over the world. Branches have got India and other countries, various other countries. So Pepsi's head office is in USA. So we say USA is the home country. United States of America, in which the head office is located, from where it operates, is the home country. And it has got branches in, say, India, Pakistan, China, various other countries. So this will become host country. Okay. So India is the host country. Suppose you take Satyam. Now it has become Mahindra Satyam. So Mahindra Satyam head office is in India, but it has got its business operations all over the world, like Japan, Germany, America. Here, there, we got various branches. So for Mahindra Satyam, India is home country, whereas America is host country. Clear? Say Samsung India Limited. Suppose if Samsung's head office is in Japan, it has got branches in India. So Japan will become home country and India will become host country. Now what is MNC defined as? An enterprise. The other day I have given you the definition. Multinational corporation is an enterprise which has extended its business operations in more than one country. Which has extended its business operation. What do you mean by business operations? Like production. Distribution means selling. Okay. All these activities are spread to various other countries apart from its own country, is called as a multinational corporation. So how it looks like? How do you identify a multinational corporation? What are the main features? Or say characteristics. For example, what is a, how a marker looks like, what are its features, means you can identify this. We can say it is so and so color, so and so shape. So they are called as features. Similarly, multinational corporations also will have certain features. Okay, the first feature of multinational corporation is large in size. MNCs are very large in size. While explaining about forms of business organization, I have told you that the size of the organization depends upon the capital. Okay, C, I have written on the board. Okay, try to understand here. Okay, how the size is increasing? This is capital. C stands for capital. So if you invest more capital, your size will be big. You can see how it has increased. I hope all of you are able to understand this diagram. As the capital is increasing, the size of the organization is increasing. So multinational corporations, any owner, okay, these companies will invest heavy amount, thousands of crores, because their operations have to satisfy the needs of the population of different countries. They have to produce goods in large quantities. They have to satisfy the demand of customers spread around different countries. So to meet those requirements, naturally a multinational corporation will invest a lot of money. As they invest a lot of money, what happens? They will have a very big building. They will have heavy machinery. They recruit thousands of employees. So automatically the size will be big. Okay, very simple. You take, if you are managing only junior college, only intermediate, your building will be very small. If you are managing junior college, degree college and PG college, you require a 5-story, 6-story building and having hundreds of lecturers, thousands of students. Okay, because of your operations only the size will increase. Okay, naturally you will be investing heavy amount. So the first one is large in size. The size of the organization will be very large. Next, international operations is very important. What is international operations? Means your business activity will spread, will reach across the border. You don't confine to one country. You produce goods in your home country. In various other countries also you will establish branches, or you produce goods and transport them, or you enter into agreement with various other franchises. Like that you will have the setup to reach, to meet the demand of customers spreading all over the world. You will be focusing on selling your goods in different parts of the world, not only one country. So naturally you will go for international operations. Next, international management is very, very important. The way you manage your organizations, the way you perform activities will be at the international standards, not ordinary. Okay, the way you dress, the way employees speak, the infrastructure level, the office look, office building, method of production, everything will be according to the international level. Next, mobility of resources. What do you mean by mobility? Moving from one place to another place. Mobility means movement from one place to another. So what you are moving? Resources like labor, capital, material. So they transfer from one country to another country. That capacity they have. This is not possible for normal companies, because in order to mobilize these resources you require a lot of money. That investment cannot be made by the Indian companies or normal public companies. This capacity is held by multinational corporations only. Then centralized control. What do you mean by centralized control? The decisions can be taken only at the home country, at the head office. Head office will deal with various activities of planning, decision making, controlling, framing the rules and regulations. All are done at head office. These individual branches have to follow the rules given by the head office. Individually we cannot take our own decisions. Individually we cannot make our own plans. That is what called as centralized management. Centralized power means when the power and authority is vested in the hands of only few people at the top. For example, you take in Hyderabad, we have got so many branches of Narayana and Sri Chaitanya colleges. But here, the principals do not have the right to prepare timetable. They do not have the right to prepare syllabus. The syllabus comes from Vijayawada. What a lecturer has to teach from Monday to Saturday, weekly schedule comes from Vijayawada, from their central office. That is called centralization, centralized power. So here we cannot transfer. What test is going to be conducted? To what extent the portion is to be completed, all is decided by the central office according to the reports sent by these lecturers. You cannot have any powers to deal individually. So similarly, in a multinational corporation, The rules and regulations are framed at the head office, and here you have to follow. That's it. You cannot make your own rules. You cannot take decisions on your own. Everything comes from the head office. That is called as centralized control. Then integrated activities. What do you mean by integration? Means combining. Clubbing of activities is called as integrated activities. Activities means the work you do, the act you perform. Okay, so when you establish your organization in the course of earning profits, you have to deal with so many things. Like, first of all, you have to go for research and development. What is research and development? Innovating the new products. What type of bikes are required by the people? What type of mobile phones are required by the people? What type of textiles we require? What methods of teaching we have to apply? So like this, lot of research is to be done before designing a product. Without proper research, if you design a product and you manufacture and you launch in the market, consumers are not going to take. You will incur heavy losses. So lot of research work will be done by these multinational corporations before launching the product. They will conduct lot of experiments that how the trend is going on. In future, what type of cars are required? What type of mobiles are required? What type of bikes are required? What type of fans are required? So for this, we require lot of research. So our work starts from research and development. Then accumulation of all factors of production. Then you have to produce the goods. Then you have to distribute them in the market. Marketing research is to be done. You have to take care of distribution activities. Normally, what happens in case of small firms is, they deal with only one activity. Certain companies are there, they only produce. They don't know how to market their goods in the market. They don't know how to distribute. That work is given to some others because they are not capable of doing that. Okay. So they assign the job to others, small companies. But multinational companies are not like that. A to Z activity is done by them. They know how to procure the material. They know how to research and develop. They know marketing research. They know production, they know distribution, they know selling, they know consumer service. All these things, with the help of their force, with the help of their management skills, they are capable of doing all the activities. That is what called as integrated activities. A to Z, whatever is required, from production to till the product reaches the consumer, including transportation, they take care of. That is their capacity. That is the reason today in the world market, multinational companies are successful. Around 70-80% of the market share is enjoyed by the MNCs, whereas the domestic companies, normal ordinary companies, are struggling to survive. Okay. Then, oligopolistic powers. In economics, you will learn types of economy: monopoly, oligopoly, perfect competition. Oligopolistic powers means when economic powers are vested in the hands of only few. Only in the hands of few persons, it is called as oligopoly. So generally in the entire world market, few companies are concentrating the economic power. Only those people have got large quantities of money. So they will have that authority. So with their powers, they capture the market. Then sophisticated technology means advanced technology. High-level machinery is used by the multinational corporations because they have got money. They don't use ordinary technology. What is the difference between ordinary technology and advanced technology? If you use ordinary technology, you have to put more resources. It takes more time. You have to spend more money. So cost of production will be more. Product will not be of that good quality. If you use advanced technology, cost of production will be less. It takes less material, less time, with minimum resources, we get maximum output. Quality of the product will be good. So naturally, customers will prefer high quality goods, not inferior quality goods. So when you apply advanced technology, naturally, the quality of the goods and services will be very good. So the MNCs will take advantage of that. Because they have got money, so they can use heavy machinery of advanced level. Then several firms means there is no need of MNC to establish its own factory and again they plan their company in various host countries. If they have to spread their market, if they have to enter into the world market, they enter in various forms like joint venture. They always need not have their own firm. They enter into understanding agreement with other companies in the form of subsidiaries. They will share the activity with existing companies. They enter into agreements with them, or they establish their franchises. Their name will be given to some others, and they monitor from their home country. Like that, it is called as several firms. So these are the features of multinational corporations. In the next class, we will be discussing about advantages of multinational corporations.